There's no doubt UFC fighters are amazing in the ring, but sometimes their wrath is felt by people who are not their opponents. For instance, the referee. While it is important for the referee to look out for the fighter's safety, sometimes it is their own safety that they need to be worrying about instead. Today, we have a list of the 7 UFC fighters who ended up attacking the referee in the ring. At number 7, Takeo Shina. It was back in 2010 when the epic battle between 2 Japanese MMA fighters made headlines across the globe. But it was not his skills that got him there, but the brutal beatdown he gave his opponent, Hyung Ying Lee, while also knocking out the referee during it all. Young Hoon Lee was making his professional debut, but it was Shina who was having a pretty good match after he handed a left-hand flush to Lee's jaw in only the opening round. But he found it hard to stop as he continued landing punches until he had to be stopped. Even after he was held back, Shina could not control the adrenaline pumping through him as he knocked out Kimura, the referee for the match. Shina ambushed Kimura by giving him a knee to the body when Kimura tried to stop the assault and seemed to present little to no guilt as he went about the ring and went back to punching Lee until the authorities grabbed him and made him stop. Because of all this, Shina was disqualified from the game, which ultimately led to an abrupt end for his career. At number 6, Vyacheslav Datsyuk. Datsyuk can easily be one of MMA's all-time craziest characters, who has assaulted a referee like it's no big deal during his time competing in combat sports. During a charity kickboxing event in Moscow, Datsyuk went up against a younger, smaller opponent and took the fight even less seriously than he normally did. Apparently, Datsyuk repeatedly marched forward, grinning with his chin stuck out as he invited his opponent to punch him in the face. He attempted to duck the incoming blows, and whenever they did hit him, he pretended to be hurt. In the second round, Datsyuk attempted an over-the-top spinning back fist, which made him slip and fall. At this stage, the referee had had enough of Datsyuk's antics and called the fight off, declaring his opponent the winner. Of course, this angered Datsyuk, who then punched the referee in retaliation. However, the official came right back at him as he pushed Datsyuk's opponent to the side and get an even better aim at him instead. Of course, Datsyuk again grabbed the official and shoved him the full length of the ring before he launched them both headfirst out of the ropes, flying into the crowd. At number 5, Wilhelm Ott. At Agrolin 19 in 2017, while fighting Nihad Nosifovic, Austrian fighter Wilhelm Ott decided to act violently when he had a late stoppage. In the second round of the fight, Ott had been taken down by Nosifovic pretty early. Nosifovic softened him up with strikes and had then applied a near-naked choke. Ott was in a pretty high choke, which led him to quickly start tapping on the mat. However, the referee appeared to not see the tapping, which resulted in him having to start pounding the canvas with his other hand before the official finally waved it off. Of course, Ott was furious and got straight back to his feet, shoving the referee against the cage and punching him in the face. Ott then continued to shout abuses at the official and threw his gum shield at him for good measure, after which others got between them and defused the situation as quickly as they could. At number 4, Razi Jabari. In the Philippines in 2011, Iranian fighter Razi Jabari got a taste of his own medicine when he attacked a referee after he had suffered a loss to Honorio Benario at URC C3. Due to ground and pound strikes, Jabari tapped out after being soundly beaten by Benario. However, once the result was read out, he squared up to the referee, who was Joy Lepitin, in the match and hit him with a weak right hook after pushing him. Unfortunately for Jabari, the referee was no pushover as he immediately retaliated by shoving the fighter back up against the ropes and taking him down before he mounted him. At the same time, Alvin Aguiar, a URCC promoter with a BJJ black belt, had also rushed into the ring and took Jabari's back, after which he sent him to sleep with a rear naked choke. After this, Jabari was banned from competing in the country again for his violent actions. Since then, Jabari has never fought in the MMA again. Number 3, Gilbert Yavel. Gilbert Yavel took on the reputation of being one of the sport's bad boys in 2004 when he attacked the referee during a fight with Ed Backman at Fight Festival 12 in Finland. In the early first round, the two fighters, Backman and Yavel, had become tangled up in the ropes while they were in a clinch, which led to the referee attempting to reset the position away from these ropes. However, Yavelle refused to cooperate and continued to swat the referee's hand aside as he ignored him, while the poor referee tried in vain to get the fight started again. As it happened, this angered Yavelle even more, and his temper eventually reached the boiling point, which resulted in his uncorking a brutal left hook to the jaw, flooring the official before kicking him while he was already down. The dazed referee tried to stand up, however, could not do much except stagger across the ring and fall back down again. After this, Yavelle was subsequently disqualified from the fight. In the years following the incident, Yavelle went on to have difficulty getting a license to fight in the state of Nevada due to his poor conduct in fights. At number 2, Conor McGregor. The superstar of the UFC, Conor McGregor has never shied away from the spotlight. However, in 2017, it was not for his amazing MMA skills that landed him in the headlines, but his need to cause trouble, including at an event in his home city of Dublin that was hosted by rival promotion Bellator's event. The Notorious, as he is called, was at the show to cheer on his longtime friend and training partner Charlie Ward as he made his debut against John Redmond. After Ward had secured a KO victory, McGregor jumped into the cage and began celebrating his fighter friend. This would all be okay if the referee Mark Goddard had officially declared the fight as being over at the time, which he didn't. So he decided to go over to McGregor and try to restore order by telling him to leave. Of course, McGregor was enraged, and he ran back over and shoved him while chastising the official for his intervention. Other officials wrangled McGregor back out of the cage. However, he stalked around the perimeter and then defiantly jumped back up on the cage to continue his celebration with Ward. At this time, a Bellator official attempted to get him to come back down from the ring. However, McGregor acted out aggressively as he slapped him in the face. McGregor did issue a half-hearted apology for his behavior later, claiming that emotions got the best of me. But besides being removed from consideration for an upcoming UFC event, for which there had already been speculation that he would not be participating anyway, he had managed to largely escape punishment afterwards. And at number 1, Roy Nelson. Even though big country Roy Nelson is not known for having a volatile personality, he did manage to lose his cool after a fight with Antonio Silva in the UFC back in 2016. In the final minute of the second round, Silva was floored by Nelson with a right hand before he went in with more blows as the dazed Bigfoot tried to regain his senses. In the total 5 blows that were landed, it was clear that Silva had had more than enough. This was when referee Big John McCarthy stepped in and waved off the fight. Since Nelson was already friends with Silva, he was pretty unhappy about having had to dish out what he perceived to be further unnecessary blows before the stoppage had finally come. He came back and planted a push kick to McCarthy's rear end as he knelt over Silva to ensure that he was okay. Nelson had acted out more in frustration than with any real intent to hurt McCarthy. However, it came after Nelson had already revealed pre-fight that he had issues with the veteran referee, so there's no certain way to determine whether or not it was done intentionally. As a result of his actions, Nelson was then suspended for 9 months with a fine of $24,000. However, the fighter and referee later managed to bury the hatchet when they came together for a video mocking the incident where McCarthy could be seen push-kicking Nelson around this time. And that's a wrap on 7 UFC fighters who attacked referees. What do you think about the relevant question to the video? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos like it. See you in the next one.